times if you wanted a practice amp. You didn't want to lug your big old TV twin or Fender twin. No, you know what I mean. Here you go, why not? Out the door. But today, I'm going to show you how to make a practice amp. Maybe out of something you've got lying around the house. That's right. We're playing through this little, what used to be an AM/FM radio. Somebody's throwing it out. Pop it open. Put a quarter inch jack on it. And we're good to go. So what we're going to do is take this karaoke machine here. We'll pull it apart and see if we can't make a practice amp out of it. All right, taking apart old radio, tape recorder, whatever it might be. Sometimes it can be tricky. If you're lucky, they'll have little arrows that point out all the screws that need to be removed. And you'll find some in the battery compartment also. And then if you get them all apart, usually get the thing apart. You know, but there could be some surprises. You know, it might be some knobs or things that get in the way. So you've got to really kind of like get in there and play with it and look at it. Like here, I've got this handle that's hanging up, but it'll come right apart. So let's move on to the next step. All right, so I've gotten this thing apart, and I actually took the back and disconnected the battery wires from the back so I have more room to work. Now this is an unusual piece in that it has a volume control for the microphone input, which the microphone's been cut off. It has a volume control for the music level also. Let me turn this around here. So we have microphone volume and music volume. Normally, if you used an old radio, you obviously wouldn't have such a thing. So what you're looking for, and in this case, I'm going to choose to not use the microphone input, though I could. You don't want to use the microphone input because there's another stage of gain, and you'd overdrive it and distort it, most likely. It's a condenser mic, so not even most likely you would. So what you want to do is go to either volume control, and tap into that, to that, what we call the high side of the volume control. So normally, if you look at a volume control, turn fully clockwise, volume control has three terminals on it. The center one's the wiper. And if you look at it from the back, as you turn it clockwise, this wiper, there's a wiper goes inside and comes around and makes contact with the next wiper off to its left. That's what you're looking to connect to. So you can either connect directly to, in this case, this volume control here. I could solder right to that. Or this actually has a cable that runs over here to the circuit board. So what you're looking for is the high side. In this case, this is the ground. You can tell it's the ground also because look at all these connections here that come together. All these little connections, lots of traces coming into one place. And if you trace it around here, this center one is the ground. If you have an ohmmeter, that's best. And usually in these circuits also the negative wire, the battery's negative, is also ground. And that's the case in this situation. Here's a battery, it's black, and it's ground. It goes to all this whole mess here. And so if I look, I supply to the center pin of this terminal here, that's where this connector goes from this volume control over to here, and that is ground. So I take my one of my guitar amplifier connectors and I solder it to a ground area. The next one I've determined is this terminal here. I'll solder it there. Now, in this case, this is the music volume, and this connects to a capacitor here, which goes into the recording circuitry. It's not necessary to take the capacitor out in this case because you're not going to turn the tape deck on, and it's not an issue. However, on a radio, you're going to find that this capacitor will go to the circuitry, and you might want to actually take that capacitor out. That will mean that you cannot play the radio anymore. One thing you could do is obviously break that circuit, put a switch in. But you can also just try it with that and then tune to a radio station off station when you're using this for a guitar amplifier. Also what I did do also on this is I cut the wires to the tape deck battery. Again, you know, I'm not going to use that, and it was just in the way as far as working on it. Super. All right, so let me go ahead and solder this wire on here, and we'll give it a test. Okay, so I soldered the guitar input one side to ground, and the ground is the shield of the guitar cable. You want to get that right, otherwise you'll have to have more hum than you'd expect. And then I soldered the wire right to there. I did not take the capacitor out of the circuitry, and I don't have any D cells. That's another issue right now. I'm running kind of bare bones here, so I've just got this battery and I'm holding it with my fingers. Let me just strum the guitar, see what happens. Well, maybe the guitar needs to be tuned, but it does work. All right, let's button this thing up. Before I turn this off, let me also make note of, it's really nice if you can get a thing like the radio or whatever that has an external power input, so that when you do want to run, you know, power plugged in, you can do that and not use the batteries. Can be really handy. Super. All right, let's button this thing up and actually plug a tuned guitar into it, see how it sounds. Okay, here we go. So I didn't button it up because I don't have batteries, and the only way I can power it up is this way. So let's just hold these little terminals on here, and if you'll play, we can at least demonstrate that the thing does work. Football pickup scene?
Yeah.
No, I mean bass. You know, it probably won't work real well on bass because the speaker needs to drive more air, but at low volume levels, it works. All right, well, that's it. That's a proof of concept, at least. Mm-hmm. So, there you go. Soldering iron, a few tools, and a piece of, you know, junk radio, and you can build your own little portable little practice amp, or just portable amp. Okay, that's all. Thanks. Right, I want to make one comment that I forgot to mention is that you probably heard more in the first amp that we played, this little guy here, how it gets distorted. You could actually overdrive the amplifier and get distortion, like a fuzz box. And it can sound pretty good sometimes. And on this one, same thing. If you have your volume up on your guitar, you're playing loudly, the volume's up on this, it'll distort. So you need to find that happy medium between your guitar level and the level of this control to get the sound you want, of course. The controls do vary as far as what they call the taper. So some of them are very sensitive, that you can turn from full open to down a little bit and it drops drastically. And so it can be a little touchy. But again, you can work between the guitar level control and this one and make it work. Cool. Well, great. Thanks for watching, everybody. Have any questions, just give a holler. I'll try to clarify, because I know that I missed a few points here and there. And enjoy. Thank you very much.